Hello everyone, we're going to be talking about how to draw for a Krita today, specifically how to draw a four ball. So the brushes I'm going to be using mainly are the airbrush soft and the blender knife edge. So with airbrush soft, I just picked different shades of black ash, so I was just going over and over. You could decide to change the color to suit whatever you like, but I wanted to draw a black and white four ball. So once you're done drawing the circles, you go in with the blender knife edge. Then this is where the main work starts. You just go up and down, in and out. Try not to drag your stylus or anything on the screen. Like, you go in a backward and forward motion, but like, once you go forward, you raise up your stylus, go backward like that. It's necessary to go forward and backward just so that it gives this kind of realistic feel as you take from the other shades, the other colors. Like, as the black is entering the ash is entering the black, it just mixes, gives it this sort of realistic feel. You could also alternate the brush, this brush size. Yeah, that helps with the whole detailing and everything. Further in the drawing, you would see where I'm alternating the brush size. You would continue this giving and taking motion till you've covered the whole circle. The next thing to do after you finish going in with the blender knife edge, like once you've covered the whole area of the ball, you'd go back with the airbrush soft and pick up the original colors. For me, it was black, ash, a bit of white. So I just put the original colors again on top of the foil ball, and with the airbrush soft, what it does is it's not hard. Like, it comes in layer, it applies the colors in layers. That's one reason I like the brush. So just lightly go over these areas. Another thing it does is it makes the lines, the strokes made by the blender knife edge, it makes it softer and not very harsh. So I also like doing it for that reason. So you can also use the blender blur for this same, to achieve the same result. It softens the edges of whatever strokes you think are too sharp. If you want a little pop like I wanted here, you should want a little pop of color. I created another layer and set color dodge. Then with this airbrush soft, I picked up the white and I was just going in like the direction of the fur. That's another important thing too. With using the blender knife edge, you should go in the direction of the fur to create the effect you're looking for. So I was just using the airbrush soft in the direction of the fur, giving different strokes. And then I still went ahead like at the middle of the ball. I still made some strokes with the airbrush soft, as you can see. Then everything now just comes down to, I would call it rendering. So you just keep on going in with the blender knife edge, keep on making strokes in the direction of the fur, keep on changing the sizes of the brush. Okay, I was almost through with the drawing and then I realized that the proportion was not really what I wanted. The proportion of the drawing to the canvas was not really what I wanted, so I resized the canvas. And how you resize your canvas is, top of your Krita dashboard, you should see an option of image. Once you click the image that appears there, a box drops down. Then among the options, you would see resize canvas. There is also scale image to new size. Those two options basically do almost the same thing. They just, with resize canvas, is the canvas you're resizing, and if your image is above the canvas, you need to adjust it with the transform tool. Transform tool is that box. It's like a box tool that has circles at each point. I don't know if I'm describing it right. If you look closer in the screen, you would see where it's being used. Yeah. So yeah, then with the transform tool, I adjusted my fur ball. I worked on it some more, adding highlights, adding dark shade, adding some more strokes with the blender knife edge. And yeah, that's it. There you have it, how to draw a fur ball with Krita. In my next video, I'm going to show you how to use this technique to draw a cat. And I really hope to see you there.